To solve the given rational equation, our goal is to clear the fractions by multiplying every fraction by what would be the least common denominator. So the first step is to determine what the least common denominator would be. So we're going to rewrite each fraction and make sure the denominators are factored. Well, the quantity x plus 1 does not factor, so the first fraction stays 9 divided by the quantity x plus 1. I'm going to go ahead and put this in parentheses, minus 5 over, well, 2 doesn't factor. This is going to be equal to 4 divided by, well, the quantity 3x plus 3 does have a common factor of 3, so we can write this as 3 times the quantity x plus 1. Now, looking at the denominators, notice how the LCD would have to contain a factor of 2, a factor of 3, and a factor of x plus 1. So 2 times 3 times x plus 1. So the LCD would be 6 times the quantity x plus 1. So now we're going to multiply each fraction by the LCD. We are not going to obtain a common denominator for each of these fractions, which is often a common error. So we'll multiply each fraction by 6 times the quantity x plus 1 all over 1. So 6 times the quantity x plus 1 over 1, and times 6 times the quantity x plus 1 all over 1. Remember, if we multiply both sides of the equation by the same thing, it does not change the solutions. So before we simplify, multiply, and then solve this, we should take a moment to list the excluded values, or the values that x can never be. And since we can never divide by 0, we know x can never equal negative 1 here or here. So our excluded value is x cannot equal negative 1. If when solving this equation we get a solution of x equals negative 1, we must exclude it. Now before we find these products, let's simplify. Notice for this first product, we have a factor of x plus 1 over a factor of x plus 1. So now the denominator is equal to 1, and our numerator is 9 times 6. So now we have 54 minus, here a factor of 2 simplifies. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 3, leaving us with 15 times the quantity x plus 1 equals, on the right side, we have x plus 1 over x plus 1, that simplifies to 1. 6 and 3 share a common factor of 3. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. Again, notice our denominator is equal to 1, leaving us with just 4 times 2, which is equal to 8. Notice the result of multiplying every fraction by the LCD eliminates all of the fractions, and now we solve the resulting equation. So now we'll distribute, and because we have minus 15 times the quantity x plus 1, we can think of distributing a negative 15. So we have 54 minus 15x minus 15 equals 8. Well, 54 minus 15 is going to be equal to 39. So we have 39 minus 15x equals 8. Now I'll subtract 39 on both sides. We have negative 15x equals to be negative 31. Divide both sides by negative 15. So we have x equals, this is going to be positive 31/15. Notice this value is not equal to negative 1, and therefore x equals 31/15 is our solution. If we wanted to, we could write this as a mixed number by dividing 31 by 15. There's 2 15s and 31 with the remainder of 1. So we could also write this as 2 1/15. But normally, we can go ahead and leave it as an improper fraction as long as it's in simplest form. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.